Okay, we're a little out of order. We're watching this the next day. It's Bethesda's E3 conference. The 20-second countdown. I think I may have seen a couple things on there. So it's. Sounds like it's something that might not be. Might be one of their weaker conferences. Should probably just start with the guy from. Just start the conference with the guy from South Park just going, "We're sorry. We're sorry. Sorry." Yeah, we'd appreciate it if you launched a game without game-breaking bugs. Yeah, he used to take a week off. But now he doesn't play Bethesda anymore. Now I'm jaded. I see you. Yeah, get us to some actually good games, please. I know you got Doom in there. And Wolfenstein. And whatever the heck that was. I get the feeling I'm gonna get content ID'd for this song. Just be like the others and not try to monetize, please. Okay, so I've heard something stupid Fallout related's gonna happen. I am not looking forward to that at all. Can you at least promise actual physical cartridges for Wolfenstein's the twins game, the two player game, whatever that was. Pete Hines. Hello, Peter. Hey, Peter. Hey, Peter, you know you got a bunch of angry gamers from last year. They're still waiting on their canvas bag. Hey, Peter, they need their canvas bag. Peter. Peter, are you listening to me? In the first ever Bethesda mea culpa. Dedicated to those who love games, who love the incredible entertainment that games provide. This past year, you fought demons on Mars and Nazis in America. You were assassins in the Empire, adventurers in Tamriel, and survivors. A lot of us. And survivors in the Wasteland. Boo. And you've embarked on these amazing adventures on PC, console, VR, mobile, or wherever and however you choose to play. And back Alexa?
You take the worlds that we create and you make them yours. You share your experiences with other players, with friends, and with family. With our game.
Oh yeah, the Alexa Skyrim thing was last year as well. That was a good bit. I think that was actually playable. It was probably the least buggy version of the game.
I've almost been at this company for 20 years. And when I first started...
Yeah, guys, can we please move on? These guys don't deserve your applause this year. Fallout 76 was shit. Next person. Fallout 76 is still shit. Okay, I'll let the applause go this time because it's for Doom Eternal. Yeah, not so celebrated right now. Bring out the bags. Bring out the bags. Bring out the bags. Don't standing owe him. He lied to you last year. And the year before that. 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 Tell me lies! Tell me sweet little lies! Tell me lies! Yeah, because you don't really make them. Why are you cheering this? Do not chant for Fallout 76.
Had a lot of difficulties at
Jesus
launch.
Christ.
And we got a lot of well-deserved criticism. But the team kept working on it, and you kept playing it.
And I don't know why you did that.
It's thanks to all of you. This game has one of the best online communities we've ever seen. We made a post-apocalyptic survival game where you can do whatever you want, and everybody's nice to each other. They don't go on killing griefing sprees. They leave food and water for the newbies and wave to each other. I don't know about you. This should give us all hope for humanity when the apocalypse does come.
Well, I think it's one of those things where they realized it was shit and it's like, okay, we're all gonna get through this together. Everyone group up. And it's shit. Wow, is that shit? Good gameplay? Less monetization? Less intrusive monetization?
Thanks, Todd. It's great to be here at E3. And thanks again to all of you for making Blades number one. As someone who's worked on the Elder Scrolls for 20 years, it's been incredible to bring this world to your phones in an all new way. We still love those classic dungeon crawlers, and it's clear you do as well. And whether you're exploring...
Turns out, you guys have phones! Oh wait, these aren't the Blizzard guys, never mind.
Featuring all new jobs and solo arena battles. An all new custom jewelry system. And a brand
Dragon quest line. Is this really something to get hyped about? Seriously, guys, can you tell me if this is something to get hyped about? Because I'm not getting hyped. It's already available.
On our arena mode for this fall, it'll feature PvP, your own guild, and visiting your friends' towns. But most exciting this year, we're also bringing Blades to an all-new platform, Switchblades.
Yay! You know, if I wanted to play Elder Scrolls, I'd just play Skyrim. I already got that on Switch. That's good.
In our booth and Nintendo's. Yeah.
How about Wolfenstein the New Order? For Switch, maybe? Or is that going to come later? Or that would that be something that comes later? Yeah, I really need to get that off my iPod. Oh, hi, Jeff and Tom. What's gonna come to this thing? I'm gonna get whipped by all of you. Well, at least it's not the Jeff that was doing the laughing. Jeff's having none of that shit. Yeah, it's actually gone from broken to somewhat playable.
We've also been working on our biggest update yet. It's called Wastelanders. And it will fundamentally change the game.
It'll make it viable? Was that a dragon? So actual NPCs, the things that they said would not be in the game, are gonna be in the game. Wow. It's like they realized that the game they created was crap and decided to make it an actual game. Yikes! What the hell was that? That's sad when one of the big selling points is that human NPCs return. Don't applaud that! Or at least don't cheer that. Golf clap it. Just a nice soft golf clap. That's all you need to do for that. The things that we said weren't going to be in the game are now going to be in the game. Where did they come from? It's up to you to choose how to interact with them and live with those consequences. You mean like an actual Fallout game? Awesome! Because we screwed you over last year, and you still don't have your canvas bags. Not playing. Still not playing. I don't care.
That's right. It's the perfect time to see what Fallout 76 and its growing community have become. We can't wait to welcome all of you. And because
I can wait.
You are going to be joining us. We thought we'd also give you a sneak peek this week at an all new game mode. Check it out.
It's called Talking to NPCs. Wait, is this the thing that they were talking about that I saw on... It really is a Fallout Battle Royale, isn't it? You know, if you were gonna make a Battle Royale, could you at least make one without... Could you make one out of the Elder Scrolls? I mean, I don't think anyone's done Fantasy Battle Royale yet. Oh, that reminds me, Godzilla was really good. Watched it last night. Actually, that's what I was doing instead of watching this. Celebrating the start of a family member's job today. Going out to see Godzilla yesterday. No.
Fuck yeah, we put a battle royale in Fallout 76.
Fuck you for putting a battle royale in a Fallout game.
Is a battle royale born from the Fallout universe. From power armor to perk cards, from camp building to contending with wasteland creatures, and of course my personal favorite, nukes. It's a great...
Seriously, if you're gonna do a battle royale, why not Elder Scrolls? Again, Fantasy Battle Royale, has that happened? You won't see me. I promise that.
Remember, everything we've talked about that's coming this year is free. We get to represent hundreds of passionate developers across four studio locations in North America working on multiple projects.
We screwed up majorly.
Our next-gen RPG, Starfield, and of course, Elder Scrolls 6. These game worlds are to all of you, and they are to us.
Sniper zooming in.
The time you spend in them is...
We got a lock on the Howard.
Keep telling us what you love, what you'd like to see us do better.
No, I'm not calling him the Todd. He hasn't earned it.
Support, but really thank everybody for believing in us. Thank you.
Oh no, he's moving. I lost the shot. No. Oh! Evil Within stuff. New one or DLC?
Hello!
Inishamase! Translation. These guys are idiots. They'll plot for anything. Nintendo. Okay.
It is an action adventure game in which you will fight paranormal enemy and the great city of supernatural evil.
Someone just had their get hype moment.
To tell you more about Ghostwire Tokyo, here is creative director at Tango, Ikumi Nakamura.
Yay! Yay! Hiyo.
Such a big stage makes me nervous. I'll do my best to speak in English.
I realize it's good to be supportive, but is that applause worthy? I have serious questions for this audience. Shinji, are you normal or paranormal? Why do I sound like Mario trying to do Japanese accent? Looks okay. Some sushi. What's power outage here? Or so we're in Tokyo, right? Is it? Uh-oh! It's left behind. It's the Rapture. Everyone just got left behind. Everyone just got taken. Oh, except for that one person down on the first floor that got left behind. Oh, doggy! You okay, doggy? Well, maybe you shouldn't have been in the red light district. Bunch of Raidens. What is going on there? intensely eating ramen noodles. Don't fear the Reaper. Come on, baby. Don't fear the Reaper. Looks all right. I'm sure it'll be fine. I mean, from what I heard, Evil Within 1 and 2 were fine.
When I'm not playing Bethesda games, I work as a mechanical engineer.
I work in a hospital. I used to work with kids.
I'm an electrician.
I'm an event planner.
In real life, I'm a systems administrator.
Program assistant for a private school for children with autism.
I'm trying to be an
Oh, that's cool. Some interesting eye makeup there, dude.
I got a YouTube channel. I make my own yarn.
I'm a social worker.
Teaching inmates.
I'm a game developer working at a video game cafe.
I've been a Doom fan since the game came out. I remember being in the 8th grade, and a buddy of mine gave me the share.
8th grade? I was 8 when I was slaying my first demons. I wanted to go there, and then I went there, and I was there. Wow.
Immersive. Love the dragons. Got it, a dragon.
You take down a dragon, you can definitely take down any illness.
If you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball. Let's hold off on dragons for everything, because we don't want to give the alternate timeline Nazis anything to do for Wolfenstein 3. Is ESO actually worthy of yelling, yeah?
I'm happy to say, Greg, the Elder Scrolls Online has a dragon. Right now, in fact, players are deep into the season of the dragon, our year-long story about...
must be the season of the worm. Just get to what the new stuff's going to be.
The extraordinary adventure it is today. The past year has been a huge success for ESO. More Game of the Year awards, millions more players have joined. So many, in fact, that we recently added more server capacity just to support all the new players in Canada. ESO just keeps getting bigger. Just a few days ago, we launched the Elder Scrolls Online elsewhere. The latest chapter...
Well, where did you launch it?
The latest chapter in the game where you're able to visit, for the first time, the homeland of the Khajiit, as well as control the dead...
You said you launched it elsewhere. Where'd you launch it?
If you haven't played it yet, elsewhere is the perfect starting point for new players. When we announced Season of the Dragon, we kicked it off by showing you a video about how dragons were unleashed on Elsewhere, and we ended with a cliffhanger. Now, I'm really excited to show you what happens next. Check out the world premiere.
Oh. Yeah, if you're riding into something that's about to fall, you probably don't want to keep riding. You probably want to slow down. And then just ride around the stuff that fell. Khajiit going to kill the dragon. What? So he's a necromancer? What is he? Okay, so it's four different guys there. Aim for the head! Make safe the city! And no, you can't do any of this in the game. Come on, when does he kill Wilhelm? Oh, there goes that wing. Ooh. Anyone got a healing spell? You showed us nothing of gameplay! Yeah! Standing O!
That's right, another cliffhanger. You may have recognized the return of Sai Sahan, the legendary Redguard Swordmaster. He's the legendary Redguard Swordmaster you met as part of the original Five Companions. He's back as the leader of the Dragon Guard, a group of dragon hunters.
Let him talk.
About the return of Sai and the Dragon Guard, which will unveil at QuakeCon later this summer. Before then, keep an eye out for a dungeon DLC adventure called Scalebreaker, which you'll see in August.
We need Anita Struthers out here.
Thank you so much for your support of the Elder Scrolls Online. We're humbled by your enthusiasm. Your enthusiasm for the game motivates us every day. You guys are seriously awesome. Thank you.
I seriously wonder if some of these guys standing up are taking the piss.
I have something else to talk about. The Elder Scrolls Online. We have several other projects, one of which we're ready to reveal tonight. And to tell us all about it is the game's creative director, Kira Schlitt.
Hi, everyone. And now, for something completely different.
Monty Python Online? Oh! Awesome! Wait, did they say this? Mobile? Actually, before I poo-poo it, is there a pogo stick? Pogo stick. Pogo stick. Is... Yes! Someone just got face-huggered? Now, can you put the original games on Switch? I saw Keen Dreams on there, but not the others.
So, there's a new branch on Commander Keen's family tree, and they're heading to iOS and Android. If you're hearing about Commander Keen for the first time, it was one of the first PC action games created by id Software in the early 90s. Boy genius Billy Blaze, whose alter ego Commander Keen protected Earth. All of us at ZeniMax Online Studios want to give a really big thanks to our friends at id for trusting us to deliver our modern take on this classic game.
But are you going to deliver?
So, tonight, as we introduce Commander Keen to a new generation of players, we're also introducing the next generation of heroes. Meet Billy. And Billy. Twin geniuses who follow in their famous father's footsteps. The new commanders are, of course, funny and powerful, but the game is also full of enemies, allies, and some really bad, bad guys. The twins build wacky gadgets from household items to save the Earth.
Aww.
Contraptions to conquer challenges.
Damn it.
And try saying that five times fast. The twins go on adventures in story mode, which tells some of the classic Commander Keen tales, as well as a whole bunch of brand new ones. In story mode, you'll overcome aliens, collect power-ups, and explore Mars and beyond.
Can you just remake the originals for... For modern consoles, please. Just do that. Or get M2 to do a port of them. Please.
We, like you, love mobile games. In addition to
Do we?
The upcoming Commander Keen,
Do we?
Millions of you have enjoyed Fallout Shelter, which has now reached over 150 million downloads and counting.
I mean, I do play them occasionally, but do we?
Collectible card games, we brought the Elder Scrolls Legends to mobile, so you could experience the Elder Scrolls in a new way.
Hey, wasn't that supposed to come to consoles? Okay. Hey, when is this coming to consoles like you said it would? With the crab there. Are you? I swear I've seen you before. Dragons, now in Elder Scrolls Legends, right? Dragons!
See? Dragons! If you enjoy other card games but are looking for something that provides a little deeper challenge, you can download Legends for free on the App Store and begin playing tonight. Legends' next expansion, Moons of Elsewhere, will be available on June 27th for PC, Mac, mobile, and tablet. You can head over to BethesdaNet to get a glimpse at the new
and consoles are coming when?
I'll see you there. Clapping. Now.
He won't see that one person there. He'll just see him clapping. Okay. What? Okay, say what you will about their games, they at least know how to present them. Which I know is only half the battle there. Or not even half the battle. What do we got? Okay. I'm still debating whether or not I want to try to get this. I don't know, maybe if it comes to, maybe if it comes to the, Games Pass PC, I might try it. Didn't see a spot where I could actually sign up for that, though. You jerk! Just tell us when we get to show these Nazis what for again. Yeah, the Cyberpilot VR game. We are bringing the guilt-free kills to virtual reality. Youngblood. That's the subtitle I was trying to think of.
With a gameplay experience that is bigger than any previous Wolfenstein game, you will have more weapons and weapon upgrades than ever before, more ways to customize your playstyle, and of course, even more evil Nazis to kill. Youngblood is set in the 1980s, 2 decades after the new Colossus. BJ Blazkowicz is missing in Nazi-occupied Paris, and it's up to his twin daughters, Jess and Sophie, to track him down. In Youngblood, you can still play by yourself, or you can partner with a pal to double up on shooting, stabbing, and killing Nazis.
Did I mention you can kill the Nazis?
Paris. Nazi country. That's where Papa is, so that's where we're going. We can find him together.
And BJ, you look like you've seen better days there. I really need to play New Order some more. I'm only a couple missions in. Pretty rockin' soundtrack. Assuming this is actually part of the soundtrack. I mean, that'd be pretty cool if you're playing through this game and you got this 80s synth music going on.
Wolfenstein Youngblood releases on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, and PC on July 26th.
Stop by our E3 booth to play this week. Thank you.
But what about those that can't stop by your E3 booth? Arcane, didn't they do Prey?
We love you too.
Hi, I'm Dinga Bakaba, I'm game director at Arcane Lyon.
Bonsoir, I'm Sebastian.
Or is it a different Arcane?
Games on Wolfenstein, we've been working on other projects at Arcane Lyon. And tonight, we're excited to announce our latest first-person action game. It's something innovative, stylish, and different from anything we've done before.
You can't say any of those words.
During what we say in French is a period de folie, a time of madness.
And now that we've given you
another Prey game,
the world, let us introduce you to
our, or is this new IP?
Rival, Colt and Juliana.
Well, he's getting around this E3. First he's in Gears 5, and now he's over here in whatever this is. Ah, you're gonna content ID this, aren't you? So is this a Prey game? Because I know they did some sort of roguelike thing in the Prey DLC last year. And we got what? Oh. Oh, Arcane brought Death Dishonored. Okay, who did Prey? Deathloop. Okay. Yeah, that looked cool.
Deathloop combines a mind-bending story with meticulously designed levels and, of course, Arcane signature gameplay that lets you approach every situation any way you like. Because in the endless clash between these two extraordinary assassins, how you play is up to you.
Plus, I think it's really fucking cool!
Yeah, leave it to Bethesda and Ubisoft to drop the F-bombs.
Yeah, maybe you should have said that in French, actually.
Maybe not.
But, it's also pretty fucking true. Because...
I thought that was French.
Unlike any other, and we really hope that you enjoy the ride.
Merci beaucoup.
Thank you very much.
It's a wonderful way to get away from all the pressures in life. I think the sense of community has really helped me as a person because I'm typically very isolated.
It's definitely very calming.
So is this a general community or is...
I could like be a hero and do all these things.
You find really creative, really fun, really talented people.
Meet people who are in my group that I've only known as a character.
Probably made more friends online than I have in real life.
The games that you bring out just helps people, honestly.
My parents were refugees from the Vietnam War, which is why I'm also fascinated by elements of war.
Playing these games just kind of put me out of the worry and stress.
I don't know who I should...
For a while.
I don't think I can make fun of these people. You're all lovely people. Can we please get to the games? Who you got there? Oh.
Fantastic worlds and telling these stories comes from a passion to deliver the very best experiences for our players. Hi, I'm James Altman, Director of Publishing at Bethesda.
And I'm Robert Duffy, Chief Technology Officer at id Software.
Let's be honest, it's id Software that we're cheering.
Tonight we have some exciting new technology to show you that can dramatically improve gaming for millions.
So for the past 2 decades, we've approached game development not by looking at what is possible today, but with a vision of what can be possible tomorrow. And at Bethesda, we're proud of our legacy of innovation, where again and again we've changed the industry. We were the first to use physics-based engines for sports games. We were groundbreakers with go anywhere, do anything, open world RPGs. We are the inventors of the first-person shooter.
Well, Bethesda isn't, but it is.
We are pioneers in downloadable content and the first to bring mods to consoles. And actually, since we first brought mods to consoles in 2016, there have been 1 billion mod downloads for Fallout and Skyrim.
Okay.
We, of course, developed the first commercially viable VR technology, revealed in our E3 booth in 2012. Yes, that is the original VR headset, held together by tape and worn by our very own Tim Willits. And of course, we are well known as developers of best-in-class engine technology with our id Tech engine.
What is it called? Id Tech? Is that what they're using for Doom and Wolfenstein now?
Creativity is in our DNA, and all of these advances were done with one goal in mind.
To make money.
So tonight we have
To improve player experiences.
We're going to show you the result of years of research and development. Cutting-edge game engine-based technology we developed specifically for game stream.
Now we'd like to introduce you to...
Bethesda's going to enter the stream space? Did I get that right?
Is a tremendous breakthrough in streaming technology. It is our name for a group of patented technologies that optimize game engines for performance in a cloud environment. Orion can work with any game engine and will improve player experiences no matter which game you're playing or whether you're streaming on Stadia, on xCloud, or another streaming platform. So, how does Orion work?
The exciting game...
Just like the creation engine. Buggy as hell, and won't be fixable.
There's a lot of work. We used our expertise in developing game engine software and took a different approach. By incorporating Orion technology at the game engine level, we're able to stream game content up to 20% faster per frame, leading to a dramatic reduction in latency. In addition, an Orion-enabled game can stream with up to 40% lower bandwidth. And happily, for game developers, Orion technology is easy to integrate with your game build with our SDK.
What does that mean for you? It means that streaming games will be faster and better with Orion. And Orion substantially reduces the cost. cost of streaming for players and for publishers. So it won't matter if your friends and family are sucking up all the bandwidth or if you live far away from a data center. With Orion, you'll still be able to stream your game at max.
Go anywhere you want. Do anything you want. And that's because the engine, it just works. It actually works perfectly.
Now, as with any new computer technology, one must ask the question, can it play Doom?
Well, we saw Stadia couldn't.
Can it stream an unrelenting, fluid, first-person shooter with native 4K resolution at 60 frames per second? Let's see.
Shale Williams, tech specialist for Mid Software, who is showing you just that here live on stage.
So Shale is streaming an Orion-enabled Doom 2016 right now to that mobile device. As you can see, there is no reduction in visual fidelity.
Well, I mean, it's a smaller screen, so even if it was reduced visual fidelity, you couldn't really tell.
Doom in their lives.
Yeah! And we'll see you in hell.
I'm assuming Eternal's up next. Yep. Here we go. Kill all sons of bitches. That's what I've written.
They are no longer your people to save.
Yikes. Oh, this is beautiful. Beautiful. And it's coming when? Oh, okay, can you stop flashing lights, please? That's bugging me. When is it coming? Hey, Hugo grew a beard since last year.
And I'm Hugo Martin, the game's creative director. As you just saw, we're not just building a world for Doom, it's an entire universe. Earth is on the brink of annihilation, being consumed by demons. And your crusade to save it will take you across dimensions.
It's kind of like Doom 2, right? Doom 2 was hell on Earth, right?
To the Sentinel homeworld and beyond. Yeah.
I think that's what it was. Yeah, because Doom 1 was
so much
on the moons of Mars, and then you went into hell itself,
about gameplay. And Doom Eternal,
and then you came out on Earth.
The ultimate power fantasy.
and then you had to beat the demons on Earth. That reminds me, I need to play Doom some more. Okay, so this is going to be the game that gets the deep dive this year. Ooh. Wait, is that even possible to jump, grab a wall, and then jump again to get somewhere else? Or is that just a creative cut? Ooh. I mean, there's a lot of creative editing going on here, but I don't know. Oh, yikes. Eat it. Which is why it's releasing tonight.
If you are lucky enough to be in the room tonight. You'll have a chance to play it immediately following the show.
I heard some guy in the audience going, "Oh, we're not getting a copy. We're just getting a demo." Okay, but what about us at home?
Let's see how it all comes together. And watch as this perfect killing machine goes to work.
Escape pod? Why are we going to Mars? I thought we were doing this on Earth. Oh boy. Mars is kind of, seen better days there. Let's roll. Is that rocket launcher? No, that's a plasma cannon. It's like a grenade thing that attaches to the monsters, and you just gotta detonate it. No blood in there. You just smash his head down into its down into its rib cage. I suppose that'll do it. that like a flat cannon there? Do I need to read up on my Doom lore again? Or Doom gun lore? Gun something. I don't know. I'm. They come back on stage, and that's just on easy mode. Where are all these guys coming from? Oh, that was nasty. And eat it. I wanted to see him explode. There's all the ammo. Yeah, that was some good, clean family fun there. Ready for round two? And it's coming when? Yeah.
Well, you don't have to wait too much longer. Not quite tomorrow.
I wish.
Doom Eternal will release on November 22nd.
Happy birthday to me! Well, 2 weeks after, but close enough.
We're very excited.
Happy birth month to me. Now this would be a place where you could have an awesome battle royale mode. But only as demons.
On behalf of our amazing team at ID in Dallas and Frankfurt, Germany, We want to thank you all so much for your support. Thanks, everyone. Thank
you. All right, let's see this. Or is it going to be a cinematic thing? Kind of sounds like the old Mortal Kombat announcer. What if it's the same guy?
Another round of applause, please, for Marty Hugo and all of our presenters tonight. And for everyone at our studios around the globe that have worked so hard in the great games you've seen tonight, we say thank you. 2019 marks 25 years of Doom, so to celebrate, we will be going all out with Doom at QuakeCon this summer. We're adding a whole host of panels and activities dedicated to Doom, which we call DoomCon. Yeah, see what we did there? We took out the Quake and put...
Yeah, just move on there, Pete. Okay, so it wasn't as bad as I thought it was. Thought people were making it out to be. I mean, obviously, you can't really trust much of what the Bethesda side of things are talking about. But I mean, Ghostwire looked fine. Deathloop looked interesting. Doom's always awesome. Wolfenstein, I'm sure, is going to be fine. So, I mean, the rest of the stuff I could do without, but, you know, part of Bethesda, you got to deal with it. Oh yeah, I'm excited and disappointed by Commander Keen. Alright, so that's Bethesda. So what do we got? Ubisoft, Square Enix, and Nintendo left. So.
Yeah. I'll see you next one.